We've had a couple of you send us the city paper thing. Wowie, wow, wow.
Look at that.
Do you know how this happened this worked? Did people vote on this?
I think it's voted on, yeah.
We won best local radio personality in the city paper. All right.
If you voted, thank you, I guess.
Yeah, I don't know how that works. I don't know if there's a voting process or anything. We've won it before, but I don't know. So, yes, we have been voted best local radio personality.
Award winners we are.
In the city paper.
Award winners.
Okay, I believe... I'm being completely honest. I believe if the city paper also had a worse local radio personality, I believe we could win that too.
We could sweep the categories.
I believe we really could. I think we're closer to being the worst local radio personality than we are the best, right? Like, I think we're closer to the bottom than we are the top.
We definitely dabble in both.
Well, it depends on what you're really looking at as far as what a personality is. Like, me and Bob are very nice, normal people. We do have nice personalities, I guess. As far as doing an actual professional radio show, though, I would say we're a lot closer to being the worst than we are the best. But here's why I bring this up. Because they have to write, like, a little paragraph about us. Right? In the city paper. They do this, like, Best of the Berg 2017 thing or something, you know? So, you know, they have a ton of Pittsburgh-related categories.
Sure, yeah.
And, you know, whoever wins these categories, they do a little paragraph about it, whatever. Best local radio personality, Mikey and Big Bob. Here is what the city paper wrote about us. These two goofs are the hosts of the Morning Freak Show, which is where you should tune in if you need your traffic, weather, and hot tunes. I'm going to be honest. Whoever wrote this has never listened to our show before.
Hot tunes?
Like, that's what you're going with top three for us? Traffic, weather, and hot tunes? it might be somebody that's familiar with our radio station, but maybe not familiar with our show. Mixed with riffs about what the Steelers did right and wrong and weird poop stories from around the globe.
They got one thing right.
That's the poop stories?
Yeah, around the globe.
So that's the paragraph right there. Traffic, weather, hot tunes mixed with riffs about the Steelers and weird poop stories from around the globe. Hey, that's it. That's the breakdown right there.
What a write-up.
By the way, do we go global with poop stories? I feel like poop stories on our show are more of a national thing.
Maybe we had a couple that went worldwide.
Really?
I don't know. Yeah.
Yeah, I got to be honest, though. Whenever there's a weird poop story from anywhere on Earth, it's going to make our show. So I would definitely agree with that last part more strongly than the other ones. I don't know if everybody's coming to us so much right off the bat. Like, got to listen to Mikey and Bob this morning. They have traffic, weather, and hot tunes. However, though, if you're looking for weird poop stories from around the globe.
Worldwide poop stories.
I can't even talk. We very may well be. Yo, it's a wrap. Shut it down. Best local radio person.
The best.
And the worst, too. Wow. Maddie tweets here, you should have your viewers create and send in paragraphs to describe your show. It'd be hilarious.
I don't know if you beat the one city paper did, though.
Greg already got one here. Florida stories, today in Freak Show history, Facebook comments, poop stories, and, of course, alien butt stuff. That's a pretty good write-up
That is pretty good.
That is a pretty good write-up.
That is.
It's a pretty good write-up right there. Not going to argue with that one at all. I love how, like, it's mostly normal, but then it's, like, weird poop stories from around the globe. That's right. Award winners, baby. Best local radio personality. And, like I said, also the worst, too. Also the worst.